Welcome everybody to this video, and in this video I would like to explain the HDRP materials issues that I was having and a solution. And the reason why is because I'm very much into HDRP these days. I think it's fascinating and fantastic, and we can do an awful lot with it. And the beauty of it is the physics-based lighting, which basically means that your lights are based on real physics, as in real world. Example is, you can go to Amazon and look at a spotlight, and then you can literally type in the the spotlight parameters of intensity. And with the texture, you can add certain reflections of the spotlight to reflect the architectural precision. With volumetric lights, there's also volumes, which is extremely interesting because you can create local volumes for things like exposure and such. You do that here, and you kind of set your fog levels. I mean, you don't really need fog. It makes it extremely heavy immediately, but your exposure levels is something that means that if you look into the sun, your pupils will, react to it. And once you can master this, there's, for me, an extreme excitement to work with these high-end materials, because now we can literally create a high-end portfolio review studio in VR that reflects the real world. But I warn you, it has been a bit of a journey. It is, for example, quite hard to find a library of materials. However, there is good news. There is a library of materials right here. And this is the measured material library from Unity. I will put a link in the description. But in working with it, I found there's quite some issues. So this video will be about how to fix some issues with the materials that I noticed and took me literally a few days to figure out, because there's almost no information online about it. A particular issue I thought was in the mask maps, which are RGB texture channel maps that I had not worked with before. But in fact, there was an issue that was in the shader, and I've never worked with that before in Unity either. But first I thought it was the diffusion profile, then I had to dig even deeper, and it wasn't, and it was something simple. So in this video, I want to just take the time to explain it, to explain the journey of HDRP, and to share that information, because there's literally hardly anything on the internet about it. So here it is, and I hope you enjoy the video, and that is the introduction. So let's dive right in. So let's say you have your Unity Hub. I don't know why it's closed. You select new project. You want to start with a HDRP project, name the project, and hit create. After a while, I close it again, that's okay. What you should see is the HDRP wizard, which will fix a number of problems for you in HDRP. But then HDRP, you have it all green, so that's all working. So let's hide that. And you want to make sure you go to the GitHub link that says Measured Materials Library HDRP. You can simply go and download the zip file and then make a package out of it or something like that. But the real problem arises when you actually import the custom package. So I've created a custom package of it. It's 1.3 gigs, so let's open it up, and then I will explain a trick that took me about a day to figure out on how to fix the materials, because they do not come in properly, and there's no documentation on the internet. I saw one person in speaking in very foreign language to me explaining something, but apart from that, there's no documentation on how to do this fix or even on how to use these measured materials libraries, hence this video. Okay, so it looks like we're almost there, and then as you can see, you have an exceptionally beautiful set of materials. It has materials, sample scenes, and it has the Unity ball, which is this guy. So you drop in a Unity ball, and actually, if you open the scene, you get a completely different situation where all of these balls already have all the materials in them, but I'll just do a few and I'll show you what the problem is. These are prefabs, I'm just going to override them, and the issue is specifically a problem with the fabrics. What you see here is they turn green, and if you drop them on your material, they are completely failing. So let's do a troll coke striped or something like that on here. And that is very strange, and I really couldn't figure it out. It's actually the only material that's failing because if, now remember, these prefabs are now overridden. If I go and put, for example, a simple car paint on it, outside layer, and as you can see, car paint. Oops. This is not going as smoothly as I wanted it to, but normally I should be able to do that. So as you can see, there are no major issues with these materials. They're all working, and you have beautiful materials. Hide those, and then if I go copy it again, and I go suede, as you can see, will also be completely green. Very weird. I checked into the mask map and I couldn't figure out what it is. It took me a while to actually figure it out. Leather is working. Okay, so leather is working. Leather is working. Let it process a little bit and you'll see it will do a nice leather. Now, what in the end of the day, what I figured out is that each of these materials obviously has a shader graph to it. So if you go there, and after a while I figured it out, you edit the shader graph. And in the shader graph, first I thought it had to do with this particular profile. But in the graph inspector here, you see it is here named as such. And what happens is very strange, but if you go to these guys, and you go to that same setting, probably another way to get there is the shader setting, for some reason, and I could only find it here, is set to lit, and this you have to set to fabric again. And then if you do that correctly, everything starts compiling again, and then after a while, I'll go back to the material, they all should start. No, I didn't save it. Okay, one more time. Go to fabric and save the asset. Yes, that's what I needed to do. And now this particular shader, which is used, fabric suede is used for a lot of materials. If you start hitting them all, you'll see that they will all come back to normal. Then you go to your scene and boom, there you have them. So with that, I just want to quickly show a scening. Make sure you got the wizard on green, that everything's good, all materials are upgraded and imported. And then check it out. The other cool thing that you can do, so here I've got another scene, and you can see here a little bit of the great lighting effect here of that sun. And what you can also see here is a little bit of that lens flare effect there, right there, you see. Small interruption because the microphone died. What that is you go to the package manager, to your HDRP pipeline that you just imported, and you click on additional post-processing, procedural sky, particle system, if you want to, you don't have to, material samples, additional lens flare samples, and local volumetric 3D texture samples. What this gives you then is an additional set of fun stuff that you see here in this 12.1. I don't know if it's the latest or not, but for example, there's a scene for your lens flare sample. Let's see, right there, you see the lens flare is a lamp It's actually light, so you can just make a prefab out of that, and then you can literally just drop that in and make a prefab out of that. You can export that and use that in your scene. The other one is the interior lighting, save, where you have these guys for free, and it just gives you a very nice setup of these two types of point light and a spotlight, all physics based. So you can also, it's very dark, but as you can see in the other scene, which is the other scene, which is there, that I also have put those lamps in. As you can see, they're very nice materials, and they're also very nicely lit. For instance, if I turn the sun off and I turn these other two ceiling lights off, not that one, it's actually on the autocalculate, I think, which is a bit stupid for the video. It's doing global illumination. You see that they give a really nice, beautiful, kind of realistic glow. Lens flare is in there, and yeah, it's doing global illumination auto update, which is not a good idea for a video, but switch everything back on again, switch the sun on again, and then also when the fog volume, which is here, call it what the fog, you can then play around with the, I think there's an issue right now, yeah, with the volumetric fog, make it a little bit more. And the bloom, of course, of the of a little bloom, don't make it too crazy. You can easily go overboard with it, as the great teacher told us. And now you should be seeing some of those rays even coming in. I saw that earlier, I don't know if you can see them now. But anyway, don't think the volumetric rays are there quite yet. This is mostly about the materials, and then about how to quickly set up a proper, well, not proper, this is just me improvising and hacking a beautiful portfolio of materials that you can build upon. And then you have the entire series of materials in there that are actually a very good basis to start with. So that's what we're going to be doing, starting with these materials, these free materials from the website. You can easily build out, is my plan, a nice a portfolio of CMNF. Get it for free at this link. It's called Measured Material Library HDRP, and it has some documentation in it as well. I had immense trouble finding an issue for this fabrics shader, so what I did, I figured it out. I spent a day, and eventually right here, just click on fabric and make sure that the material is on HDRP. For some reason, it was not. So here are the shader graphs, and you have it on fabric suede. That's okay, that's fine. But then if you go in there, you still need to put a graph setting also updated, and that for some reason didn't work. Don't forget to save your asset up here on the left. And that's it for the video. Thank you very much.